can think about metabolism as having kind of two major sides, anabolism and catabolism. So anabolism is the building up of larger molecules from smaller subunits. So this might be like the synthesis of these kind of larger macromolecules like fats or carbohydrates or proteins. And our cells will make these from building blocks in order to support the needs of the cell at any point in time. And then catabolism, which is kind of the side that we generally are thinking about when we're talking about metabolism in terms of like how the food that we eat affects our body, is the opposite side. It's taking those larger molecules and breaking them down into smaller units so that our body can use them as building blocks for other processes or for the creation of ATP, which is the cellular energy currency. A human brain is uniquely large. It is over 3 times larger than our closest living relatives, the chimpanzees. It's much larger than early humans. And even though it's relatively small, only making up about 2% of our body weight, it uses over 20% of our total body energy, which is a lot of energy. So it's a very energetically demanding organ.
We know that B vitamins and especially B12 is important for optimizing our internal energetic processes. So like our mitochondria, our red blood cells actually use B vitamins to increase enzymatic efficiency, to increase the ability of the machinery to work. So we're basically trying to make sure that you have the optimal level of B vitamins to improve energetic and metabolic function. You look at CMED and you look at exogenous ketones, the CMED's actually helping DNA. So what we're finding is that combination of the two is the ultimate combination.